Hello, welcome back. Governments collect much data, and this data might be published as open government data and might be used by the public. So what are the processes for collecting, publishing, finding and using governmental data? And which actors are involved in these processes? In this video, we will be exploring these issues. After this video, you should be able to A. describe the basic processes of the collection, publication, finding and use of open government data, and B. to describe the actors involved in these processes. So let's start with the basic government data processes. First, the data is created. Government agencies and publicly funded research organizations produce, collect, and integrate large amounts of data each day. They collect this data to be able to fulfill their ordinary tasks. For instance, the Ministry of Justice collects data about the number of crime victims in order to create its crime prevention policies. And the production of this data is funded by public money. Second, public agencies and publicly funded research organizations decide whether they will open their data on the internet. We often refer to the term data publication when data is opened. Data can be published on the website of a governmental organization, on a national portal, on other portals, or on different combinations of relevant portals. Governmental data is published on the internet increasingly and is referred to as open data. Third, potential data users can find this data by searching open data portals. This can be done manually. However, nowadays this is also often done automatically by machines. For instance, application programming interfaces or APIs can be used for this purpose. And since open government data is provided through a large variety of portals, finding the data that someone is looking for can be challenging, especially if he or she does not know whether the data exists and which government organization creates or collects the data. Then, users may be looking for the needle in the haystack. Fourth, when open government data is found, it can subsequently be used. Often, the data user needs to download the data to be able to work with it. Open government data can be used in many different ways. For instance, by cleansing, analyzing, visualizing, enriching, combining, and linking it. Data cleansing refers to detecting and correcting records in a dataset. Data cleansing could be a goal in itself, but it is often performed to make it easier to use a dataset in another way, for instance, by analyzing it. Analyzing a dataset could merely mean reading, that means looking at the dataset, and deriving useful information from this activity. But it could also refer to conducting a thorough statistical analysis by using software such as SPSS statistics. An analysis of a dataset could lead to new insights and understanding of the data, possibly by analyzing data in a way that was not done before. Also, visualizations often provide much insight in a dataset. And datasets can also be enriched in several ways. For instance, a user could annotate a dataset by describing his or her experience of using the data, or by noting which information other users should take into account when they are using the data. A dataset can also be enriched by adding information that was derived from the statistical analysis or visualization. Another important way of using open data is by combining data with other datasets or by linking it to other data, as this reveals the relationships and the correlations between datasets. Now, data interpretation is very important for each of these steps of open data use. For instance, in order to analyze or combine open data sets, the user needs to be able to interpret the data and to understand the context in which it has been created. In sum, we just explored four basic processes, namely those of collecting data, publishing data, finding data, and using data. Now, too often, governments focus on publishing, but not on learning from the usage, which in turn can result in improvements of, for instance, the governmental publishing process. So now we turn to our second learning objective. So which actors are involved in the processes of collecting, publishing, finding, and using governmental data? First, we saw that data providers are involved, since they supply the governmental data to the public. For instance, this can be international, federal, regional, or municipal government agencies, such as the European Commission, the federal government in the United States, and the municipality of Rio de Janeiro. Second, open data users, or the public, is an important actor category. There are different types of users, including entrepreneurs, developers, citizens, researchers, journalists, archivists, and librarians. Civil servants themselves can also be users of governmental data when they are using data provided by other governmental agencies, for example. Data providers and data users are the two key actors. There may be tensions between data users and data providers, since they have different interests. Furthermore, open data users depend on governmental data providers for obtaining the data that they need. This means that if governments want their data to be used by the public, they need to publish this data in a findable and a usable way. And this may seem simple, however, providing data in a findable and usable format can be complicated. For instance, governmental organizations may have collected and published data in a format that is not preferred by open data users, which can be a barrier for using the data. In sum, before the public can obtain insight from government data, this data needs to go through several processes of data collection, publication, finding, and use. Governments and publicly funded research organizations are involved as data publishers, and the public is involved as data users. Here are the references related to this presentation. Thank you for your attention.